Hi, I'm Kobayashi from Sony. In this video titled Neural Network for Beginners, I'll explain from setting up to running a sample project using Neural Network Console for Windows, which is an integrated development environment of deep learning. First of all, if you want to know what deep learning is or how to use the cloud version, watch the dedicated videos. Please see the description box to find the link. Let's start with how to set up the Windows version. It's very easy to set up Neural Network Console. Just extract the zip file downloaded from the Neural Network Console website to a folder you like. Then the basic setup is complete. However, there are a few points. Neural Network Console does not support 2-byte characters, so make sure the folder to which you are extracting does not contain kanji or hiragana in its name. Moreover, you need write permission for this folder, so you need to be careful not to install to folders that users don't have write permission, such as folders under program files. If you are not sure, the safest way is to unzip right under C drive. When redistributable package of Visual Studio 2015 is not installed, refer to a corresponding manual and install it. If you want to do the training using GPU, you don't have to additionally install CUDA or CUDNN for Neural Network Console. However, only GPU drive must be updated to the latest.
When you are installing Neural Network Console for the first time, or updating Neural Network Console, make sure to always download the latest GPU driver from NVIDIA website and install. When you start the execution form file of Neural Network Console, the screen looks like this. Here are the tips of setup I have explained. You need to install the redistributable package of Visual Studio. You need to update the GPU driver to the latest if you use NVIDIA GPU. If you have already done this, just click the OK button. Here, the setup screen is displayed.
For the license, see the end user license and click I agree. If you use GPU, select processor type in this engine tab. If you do this when the NVIDIA GPU is not installed or when GPU other than NVIDIA is mounted, errors will occur. To avoid this, select CPU that is selected as the default.
The setup is complete. Next, we're going to open a sample project. Various sample projects are displayed like this. Click the sample project at the top, titled Logistic Regression. When the sample project is opened, a message is displayed promoting download of dataset that is necessary in this sample project. Click Yes to start the download. Wait a few minutes until the download is complete. Now the download is complete. When an error occurs during download, it is possible that the PC is not connected to the internet for some reason. Especially if you are using a proxy server, you need to do a proxy server setting during setup, so refer to a manual and do the proxy server setting on Neural Network Console. So we would like to look through the content of the sample project, Logistic Regression.
A few tabs are displayed at the top like this. Click this dataset tab. Then you can see that some images of numbers 4 and 9 are loaded here.
And you can see that when X is an image of 4, Y is 0. And when X is an image of 9, Y is 1.
This means that we are creating an image classifier that distinguishes images of 4 and 9.
In Edit tab, a neural network like this is designed. This neural network has four functions that are input, affine, sigmoid, and binary cross entropy. The input function inputs an image of 4 and 9 from the dataset we saw.
Then, affine function does the process of multiplications and additions. That is, the neurons of 28 by 28 pixels in the input layer are fully connected to a single neuron.
Then, sigmoid function converts to the probability ranging from 0 to 1. At last, in the Edit tab, you can see that In the designed neural network, binary cross entropy calculates the deviation between the output 0 or 1 from the neural network and the dataset Y that is given. If you want to know the details, refer to another video titled Basics of Designing Neural Network, in which I am explaining the details.
Now let's execute this sample project and do a training for distinguishing handwritten digits 4 and 9. Training execution is quite easy. You only need to click this Run Training button located in the training section. The training process of the neural network has started. If a graph is displayed like this, you can see that the training is in progress in the right way. When the training is complete like this, we can say that the image is already classified at this point. As I always say, deep learning is easy. Using Neural Network Console, you can do an image classification with one click.
Then we are going to see how accurate the neural network is. In order to evaluate the performance, click Run Evaluation button located under Evaluation.
The evaluation is carried out by doing image classification for data other than the data we use for training.
The results are here already. This X is the image used for evaluation. The Y is the label given by the human showing that the image is 4 or 9.
When the image is 4, Y is 0. When the image is 9, Y is 1. A column Y dash is added next to Y. This is the answer by the neural network after the training. In this project, the value of Y dash represents the probability of being 9. For example, the probability that the first image of 4 is 9 is 0.0459. It is 4.59%, which is very low. Thus, we can say that the neural network successfully classified the number as 4. For the next image of 4, the probability of being 9 is 0.00239, which is 0.24%. So we can say that the neural network successfully classified the number as 4. For the next image of 9, since the probability of being 9 is 99.55%, the number is correctly classified as 9.
If you want to see how much accuracy the overall neural network has, click the confusion matrix. Then the accuracy is displayed as 0.952, which is 95.2%, meaning 4 and 9 are correctly distinguished.
Now you can see that by using Neural Network Console, how easy an image classifier can be created. This time we used a sample project that is prepared beforehand. In the next video, we would like to create a project from scratch and learn about image classification.